welcome to East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. It's the Jeep Celebration event. Lease a Grand Cherokee for only $289 a month. Save big this fall at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us!
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
It's golf season, and now's the time to get to Gordon's Golf Ski and Snowboard for everything golf. Gordon's carries all the high-quality brands of clubs, including Ping, Titleist, Mizuno, Callaway, and TaylorMade. Get your old clubs repaired, reshafted, or regripped. Come in today and let our teaching pro find the right fit for you. We have a wide selection of clothing, including Travis Matthew, Adidas, Oakley, Mizuno, and Puma. We have Echo and FootJoy shoes, too. The Sky Caddy GPS is a must-have for every golfer. Gordon's Golf Ski and Snowboard, East Arlington Boulevard, Greenville.
Full Service Flooring is your exclusive platinum dealer for Carndean Design Flooring. By offering a wide and impressive range of colors, textures, and finishes, you can create the looks that are unique to your home and guaranteed to last for years. Stop by Full Service Flooring today and check out our design table that makes your creations come to life. With the largest and best collection of luxury vinyl tile in Carndean, Full Service Flooring has just what you've been looking for. Visit the new showroom just off Fire Tower Road behind Chick-fil-A or give them a call at 756-9308.
When you're on the go, it's Trade Wilco. No matter where you go in Eastern Carolina, there's sure to be an attractive and always clean Trade Wilco Hess station nearby. For the absolute lowest prices on gas, groceries, and travel necessities, stop at any of the Trade Wilco Hess stations throughout Eastern Carolina. Keep your eyes on the road, but remember to look for the green and white Hess sign. The best part? No one supports the ECU Pirates more. So when you're on the go, it's Trade Wilco.
Pitt County contains over 73,000 real property parcels, which are divided into over 900 neighborhoods. Pitt County assesses all property annually through the revaluation process. If you want to know more about revaluation, just call Pitt County Tax Administration at 902-3400 or email us at pitttaxassessor@pittcountync.gov.
Uptown Greenville invites you to Freeboot Fridays, a celebration for pirate fans of all ages. Feast on fantastic food served by Uptown restaurants. Enjoy a cold beverage in the beer and wine garden. Dance to live music. The Freeboot Fun starts at 5 p.m. and continues until 8 p.m. at the Five Points Plaza. Visit UptownGreenville.com for more information on Freeboot Friday, the official pep rally of home football games.
Welcome to East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. It's Ram Truck Month. Lease a new 2015 Ram for only $289 a month. Save big this fall at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us!
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
Now on Two Big Sticks. Twice the laughs, twice the information, twice the pant size. Hey, wait a minute, that doesn't sound right. This is Talk of the Town with Henry Hinton. News, laughs, community information, and all the knowledge you need to be the smartest one in the room. Unless you are in the same room as Henry, of course.
Oh, shut up.
This is Talk of the Town on 103.7 WTIB and 94.1 WNBU.
Okay, here we go. Hour two here on the 22nd day of October. Good to have everybody with us this morning. We are live in the studio this morning, and of course, it's game day here in Greenville. Tomorrow morning, live on location at 400 St. Andrews. It is our celebrity waiters breakfast. We've been waiting for this. It's going to be a big time tomorrow morning. All the big celebrities in town, except Heather. Except for Heather, are going to be at 400 St. Andrews tomorrow morning. They're going to be waiting on the tables. Rochelle and Brian Brown from Rep Express Catering are going to be providing the food for free. It's the monthly community breakfast that we've done for years with Rochelle and Brian. But this is a special day because normally we ask you to just come eat breakfast and socialize and enjoy yourself. Tomorrow we're going to ask you to leave a tip. And you should tip your waiter depending on how well he or she does in serving you. And they're all going to be local celebrities here in Greenville that are going, I mean, and a lot of folks from ECU, the athletic director Jeff Compher, some of the coaches are going to be out there, some of the politicians, the mayor, the chairman of the county commissioners, the new police chief, the fire chief, Trent McGee is going to be waiting. He doesn't know it yet, but he's going to be waiting tables. We've invited Walter
big tips,
Jones.
Big tips, big tips.
We don't know if Walter's going to show, but we've invited him. We're going to. He may or may not get back. There's a little something going on in Washington, I think. He may not make it back. So, but we're going to be there tomorrow morning at 7 to 9 at 400 St. Andrews. And it's all a fundraiser. The tips will all go to the Family Support Network. So we're asking you to come out tomorrow morning, get free breakfast, and leave a tip for the Family Support Network. All right, 10 minutes after 8. By the way, you can bring a check from your business. If you want to write a check for, $25, $50, $100, or if you just want to leave a $5 tip. But anybody who lives less than a $5 tip, we're going to call you out and call you cheap.
Ooh.
You got to at least leave a $5 tip, right?
It's the least you can do.
The food's free. So right. Come on out tomorrow morning and be a part of the Family Support Network Celebrity Breakfast, courtesy of the guys at 400 St. Andrews. Thanks to Brian and Rochelle for doing that. All right, lots to get to. It's game day. I'm putting my game face on. Tonight is a big night.
Yes,
we've
got
a lot of coverage on the station, on our sports station today. 94.3 The Game is where you always get the best coverage of ECU football. And today, of course, you got Dan Patrick today at 9. He may be talking about the game since the national TV game tonight. But you can believe David Glenn from 12 to 3 today will be all over it. And then at 5 o'clock this afternoon, we've got our Pirate Tailgate Show. It's going to be originating live from the Texas Roadhouse. The East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep sponsors the show each week. And it's going to be live at Texas Roadhouse tonight. So come by and get some fall-off-the-bone ribs. Take them out to the tailgate lot with you. Be a great spot to get your tailgate food tonight. Come by and see David Hollinger and the guys. And Patrick Johnson, some of the former ECU players out there tonight from 5 to 7. I know Jay Sonhalder is going to be there. Philip Henry, maybe. Is Philip going to be there tonight?
I have not heard that Philip will be
Pat
there.
Jones.
Jay will be there, yes.
Jay Sonhalder. Ladies.
You know who else is going to be at
the
game
Jay
tonight?
Will be there. Jay always seems to draw a crowd of young ladies when he shows up. Yeah.
He's a ladies' man.
Yeah, he's first a ladies' man.
First and foremost.
He might buy you a bottle of Cavassier.
He might do that. And then, yeah. Shane Carden will be at the game tonight.
Oh, is he?
You know,
how
we had that? Shane on the show last night, and Shane
you know,
said
I had a
ticket.
Family get together in my neighborhood last night.
One you know, of my, things come up.
Miss
okay.
Maggie turned 90 last night, so the whole neighborhood got together. Maggie, we love you.
I would have given Miss Maggie
lady.
A shout out. Did not
and
know
so
that.
I missed your show, but you did have Shane Carden.
Shane did come through, and he said he was getting a ticket. He had a ticket to fly in today, and would actually be tailgating tonight. So.
Where's Shane living?
He's in Houston right now.
Back with his folks.
Mm-hmm.
What's he going to do?
He's said, you know, I'm still working out, staying in shape. You know, could get a call. He said, I've looked into some CFL things, some possibilities with that.
I think he might be okay at the CFL.
He's
like
looking
to see
some
Shane
arena league things, but
there.
He said he is not giving up on the possibility of, you know, making an NFL roster in the future.
Yeah. So, well, good for him.
Yeah.
Well, that's great. So Shane will be here tonight.
Shane's going to be back tonight.
Awesome. Maybe he'll stop by Texas Roadhouse and get some fall-off-the-bone ribs.
He should.
Some of that great barbecue chicken.
Mm-hmm.
Heather King is at the news desk this morning. We haven't had a lot of time to talk to Heather because we've had so much stuff going on this morning.
Busy day.
But we got to get that beautiful purple dress on television. That's
dress.
Yeah. So the game is tonight. And we're going to all be out there tailgating. Are you going to the game or not? Because you got to get up at like 2 in the morning.
Tomorrow is going
to
be extremely early.
Creswell. You've got your cool school thing tomorrow.
Yes. Tomorrow will be
and
earlier
you're going
than
to Creswell
usual.
High School.
Yes.
When I was in high school, believe it or not, 142 years ago,
mm-hmm.
the conference that I the high school conference I was in, Creswell High School was in our conference.
Okay. So you.
So I played sports at Creswell High School. For many, many years, baseball and basketball.
Nice.
Yeah.
Can't wait to
and
go.
They always beat us. I was at Chowan High School. They were at Creswell. But
yeah.
They always had great athletes over there. Had some really good athletes over there. But Creswell's a nice place, and you'll meet some nice people tomorrow.
We know we will. It's going to be an awesome show based on the plans that the school and I have come up with so far. So it's going to be a good time.
Do you plan that out with the schools?
Yeah. We work together all week long and discuss what options they have, and we kind of fit the show together and – you know, will this work? Will that work? Yes, no, maybe so. And
when you go to a place like Creswell High School, I bet they just go nuts.
I bet they do, too. They
all the kids go nuts.
They think Savannah Guthrie has walked
no,
in.
No, half of them do not know who we are, which is fine. But they're just excited about their school.
Yeah.
And they're in a contest to win a free concert. So that is pretty good incentive.
Who is the free concert this year?
It is Kaya Stewart, who is the daughter of Dave Stewart, who was in the Eurythmics. I don't know if you remember that band from the 80s.
Dave Stewart had a hit.
No, that band.
Dave Stewart had a hit on his own, didn't he?
I don't know that, but
didn't Dave Stewart have a
the
hit?
Google
maybe?
Machine going over there with Trent.
I don't know.
Also,
Google McGee.
I'm on it. I'm on it.
Today starts early voting in Greenville. We had a little voter information segment last hour with Michael Overton and Terry Williams. You know, I've been on the fence about the bond. I think I'm going to vote against it. I think they just, you know what pushed me over the edge right then, I think? Number one, I hate the fact that the city council threw in pet projects on it. And I know how bad we need the city streets, but they have to come up with another way because, I mean, it's the city council's fault they put these projects in there. But, you know, when Michael just said, and I didn't know this, that they can, even though it's $15.8 million and it's supposed to be this much for roads, this much for sidewalks, this much for streetscapes, when Michael just said they can actually move that money to other projects, so they can tell us it's going to go to this, but they can actually spend it on that. That did it for me. Because, I mean, you either trust this group or you don't, and I don't. I don't trust this group. This group has proven to me time and time again that their priorities are not my priorities. And I want to see the streets fixed. And, you know, throwing in that pet project into the bond and then saying to the voters, like Calvin Mercer says this morning, the bond must pass. I mean, it's arrogant, and it's like saying, you know, it's got to pass, even though we have thrown our own projects in there that nobody wanted but us. So, people have to make their own decisions about it, but, I think I've just made mine. So, there you go. And I hate
it. It lies with the voters.
I hate it because we need the street. We got to find a way to do the streets. But, you know, the city council, if the bond fails, they'll have nobody but themselves to blame. And I'll tell you, I've never seen a worse effort at trying to get a bond passed. If you go back to, look, I was on the bond advisory committee for the half-cent sales tax for the county years ago when we were trying to get extra money in to build some schools in Pitt County, which we were in desperate need of. Because Pitt County's growth had outgrown the ability of the county budget to build the schools. So, you know me, I never like increasing taxes, but I was for that one, and I actually agreed to participate. And I'll tell you, we started meeting 9 months in advance of the vote. We put a group of advisory together. We went out and we actually had meetings with people in the community about it. We raised private dollars and bought advertising to promote and say to the citizens of the county, this is why you should support it. I haven't seen any of that going on. I haven't seen any of that going on.
You're right. I mean, I remember the advertising for the school bond years ago, and it's a very different story.
I mean, has anybody seen heard a radio ad or seen a television ad or even a newspaper ad? I know they sent some, they'll probably buy some newspaper ads is my guess, if they have any money. But I don't know if they've got any money. They haven't gone out and raised any money. So I don't really understand it. But
well, you know, Michael's right. The projects, the specific projects in the bond could change over time. So it's whether or not It's whether or not the voters want to give local government, the right to authorize, funds to do this.
I said from the beginning, if they wanted to put that $750,000 into the bond for the greenways, I'm not against the greenways. I'm just against the way the city council snuck it into the bill, into the ordinance.
Now, I'm not saying that will happen. I'm just saying they could change over time. It's a lengthy process.
I went to the city and said, it is my opinion, just as a citizen, it is my opinion that the citizens should be allowed to vote on these five issues one per one, instead of saying you got to vote yes or no on all five issues. And the response that I got from the city was, Henry, you know that won't pass that way. And I was like, case closed. I mean, so again, You got people that they've slid stuff in that they want you to pass, even though they know that people are against it. so I can't support it. I was actually considering supporting it anyway, simply because I know how bad we need the funding for streets. But they're going to have to, you know, if it doesn't pass, it's their fault, and they're going to have to find another way to get the money for the streets. That's the way I look at it. They could come back with another bond in in March or November, and do a just a street bond, which is what they probably should have done.
Well, you wonder if you pair the bond that we know is already coming in March from the state with a local bond, if that would maybe decrease its chances because people will be worried about paying more money twice from the same vote. So that may not be the best strategy. Maybe it would be a good strategy because people are going to go to the polls for it.
Yeah. Well, I can't vote today, so I still have time to change my mind, but somebody's got to change it. I'm not there now. All right, 20 after 8. Don't forget the celebrity breakfast tomorrow morning. It's Thursday, and we play Genius Quiz on Thursday, but we normally play it in the 7 o'clock hour. Heather, have you got time for us to play Genius Quiz? I like when you're here and we play Genius Quiz.
Because I never know the answer.
Michael, are all the phones working now? Did we get the phones working? Oh, great. Michael gave me the I don't know. How much longer does it take to get the phones fixed?
I'm talking to them today. Again.
Wasn't that what he said last Thursday?
And I did talk to them.
Okay.
Hey,
all right, let's go to break. Here's what we'll do. We'll open up the phone lines right now.
It's like the bond, Henry. These projects could take several years.
That is correct. That is correct.
We're going to play Genius Quiz when we come back. And here's the deal. We've got a $25 gift card to Rucker John's. We've got a gift bag from Miss Ann's Dumplings, and we've got an oil change from Dave Davis's East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. The $25 gift card to Rucker John's can be used here in Greenville, Wilmington, or Emerald Island. Don't forget, by the way, Rucker John's, Thursday nights, Rucker John's has their party on the patio. They'll have it tonight, live music, $5 appetizers, drink specials at Rucker John's, and you can win a Rucker John's gift card right now. Call us right now, 561-8255. 561-8255. If you get a busy signal, call back. Just keep calling because we may not have all the lines working. But call right now, 561-8255. 561-8255. We're going to break. We'll be back with the Genius Quiz.
This month, not only will Greenville Toyota cut your payment in half, but you'll always get the Greenville Toyota Advantage, including oil changes, tire rotations, courtesy shuttle, free car washes, and loaners for life. At Greenville Toyota, if you give us 15 minutes, we can lower your payment.
It's golf season, and now's the time to get to Gordon's Golf Ski and Snowboard for everything golf. Gordon's carries all the high-quality brands of clubs, including Ping, Titleist, Mizuno, Callaway, and TaylorMade. Get your old clubs repaired, reshafted, or regripped. Come in today and let our teaching pro find the right fit for you. We have a wide selection of clothing, including TravisMathew, Adidas, Oakley, Mizuno, and Puma. We have Echo and FootJoy shoes, too. The SkyCaddy GPS is a must-have for every golfer. Gordon's Golf Ski and Snowboard, East Arlington Boulevard, Greenville.
Pirate Nation, the East Carolina men's and women's basketball seasons are almost here. You won't want to miss the excitement in Midgey's Coliseum all season long as the Pirates tip off against fierce competition, including five NCAA tournament teams and the three-time defending women's national champion. Take advantage of affordable family fun. Order your basketball tickets today by calling 800-DIAL-ECU or go online at ecupirates.com. Pirate Basketball, this is Undaunted.
Full Service Flooring is your exclusive platinum dealer for Carndean Design Flooring. By offering a wide and impressive range of colors, textures, and finishes, you can create the looks that are unique to your home and guaranteed to last for years. Stop by Full Service Flooring today and check out our design table that makes your creations come to life. With the largest and best collection of luxury vinyl tile in Carndean, Full Service Flooring has just what you've been looking for. Visit the new showroom just off Fire Tower Road behind Chick-fil-A or give them a call at 756-9308.
Pitt County contains over 73,000 real property parcels, which are divided into over 900 neighborhoods. Pitt County assesses all property annually through the revaluation process. If you want to know more about revaluation, just call Pitt County Tax Administration at 902-3400 or email us at pitttaxassessor@pittcountync.gov.
My prescription refills.
My son's shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant My Chart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MyVidant to learn how you can sign up.
Why pay $300, $400, even $500 a month for a new car when Greenville Toyota can cut it in half? The average car payment is $482 a month. Our average payment is less than half. At Greenville Toyota, if you give us 15 minutes, we can lower your payment.
Okay, it's a rare 8 o'clock hour Talk of the Town Genius Quiz brought to you by Rucker Johns this morning. We've got a Rucker Johns $25 gift card for the winner this morning. We've got a gift pack from Ann's Dumplings, and we've got an oil change from Dave and Chip Davis at Dave Davis's East Carolina Chrysler Dodge. Did you hear Dave and Aaron Davis? Chip and Aaron Davis had a little baby boy yesterday.
Oh, hooray. Congratulations.
Little David Wells Davis. It's another Dave Davis.
That's wonderful.
There's a bunch of them. We're happy for them. All right, let's go to the phones. And Jim, good morning, Jim.
Good morning.
Where are you calling from, Jim?
Winterville.
Winterville. Are you voting today?
No, not today, but I will vote early, though.
All right, I am too. All right, Jim, here's your genius quiz question. According to a new survey, this is something we give as a gift more often than we buy it for ourselves. Think about that for a second. What are the gifts that people buy for weddings? And it's a good wedding gift, isn't it, guys?
I don't know the answer yet.
I thought I told you the answer.
Yeah, I think so.
It's a good wedding gift. So this is something you would buy for someone else as a gift before you'd buy it for yourself. What do you think it is?
Wow, let me think here right quick.
5 seconds.
I don't know, Henry.
Take a guess. What'd you buy for your last wedding gift?
Beep, beep.
Jim, you're drawing a blank.
I know.
Right.
Well,
thanks for the call. We're off to a rousing start. Crystal. No, it's not Crystal. All right. Thank you, Jim. That'll open up a line. 561-8255. 561-8255. Call right now. We only have one line available working, so we have to wait for the line to clear, and then I have to ad-lib, and Michael tells me who the next caller. This is like the old days of radio back in Edenton over at WCDJ. Gordon. Gordon, good morning, Gordon. Where are you calling from?
Greenville.
All right, Gordon, did you hear the question? According to a new survey, this is something we give as a gift more than we buy for ourselves. And my hint was, a lot of people give this as a wedding gift, but they generally don't buy it for themselves that often. What do you think it is?
A gift certificate.
No. I guess that makes sense.
You don't buy yourself a gift certificate.
My first reaction was not positive, but I mean, the more I think about it, yeah, you don't buy gift certificates for yourself. But that's, yeah. All right, 561-8255. Got a Rucker Johns $25 gift card for you. Gift pack from Miss Ann, including one of their cookbooks, and also an oil change from Dave Davis. Sam, good morning. Where are you this morning?
I'm in Newport.
Sam in Newport. All right, Sam, according to a new survey, this is something we give as a gift more often than we buy it for ourselves. What is it?
Gee.
Huh?
You got me stumped really bad.
You got to be a genius.
Give us a gift.
Something you would get. Think about what you'd give as a wedding gift, but you probably wouldn't buy it for yourself, but you'd buy it for somebody else.
Cookware.
Okay. Yeah. No, that's not it. All right. That'll open up a phone line. You know,
I have a hint.
It just reminded me that I got to give the area code because people down in Jacksonville get mad if I don't give the area code.
Okay.
252-561-8255. 252-561-8255. Kathy.
Yes.
Good morning. Where are you calling from, Kathy?
Greenville.
All right. McGee has a hint for you.
All right. Here's my hint. Think kitchen.
Good hint.
Think
according to a new survey, this is something we give as a gift more often than we buy it for ourselves. Kathy, it's a gift. Think kitchen, according to McGee. What do you think it is?
A can opener.
Good idea. We're getting warm.
That's a good guess.
We're getting warm. We're into the appliance genre now. 561. You know what it is now?
Yes.
Heather knows what it is. 561-8255. Who is it, Michael? Randy. Randy Watson. No, Randy. Good morning, Randy. Where are you calling from?
Here in Greenville.
All right, Randy, according to a new survey, this is something we give as a gift more often than we buy it for ourselves. It's a kitchen appliance.
Is it a kitchen appliance?
We now have established it is a kitchen appliance. We're going to have to say the word, I think. People often describe me as one of these with a lid off. I was once described as one of these with a lid off, huh?
It's not a refrigerator.
No, nope, not a refrigerator. All right. That opens up a line. 252-561.
Henry, that refrigerator.
I'm a refrigerator with a lid off. 252-561-8255. $25 gift card to Rucker John's. By the way, Rucker John's, party on the patio tonight. Live music, $5 appetizers, drink specials going on. You can stop there. Another spot you can hit before the game tonight. Is it Kathy? Kathy, where are you calling from?
Greenville.
All right, Kathy, what do you think it is?
A food processor.
Let's go to the judges.
I mean, basically.
What's another name for that?
A blender.
Yes! Is that the same thing? A food processor and a blender is not the same thing, is it?
Yeah, we'll kind of give it to her, right? Kind of give
you
it to her.
Well,
but here's the thing. But there's, you know, I thought it might be the same thing because on the blender it always says process.
Yeah.
You can do it for both.
Yeah, you can. Yeah. Right?
Look, you don't have to keep selling. We bought it, Kathy.
Good.
We bought it. Plus, we're running out of time for this segment, so you're the stinking genius. All right, Kathy, what is your last name?
Floyd.
Kathy Floyd. Yeah. Hey, Kathy Floyd. This is one of America's great human beings right here. Love Kathy Floyd. How you doing?
I'm good.
All right, Kathy. You're the stinking genius.
Now.
Yeah, exactly. The answer was blender. According to a new survey, you buy a blender as a gift more often than you buy it for yourself.
Someone called you a blender with a top off?
Yeah, I was once called a blender with a top off.
It's Henry.
I won't get into that. But. All right, Kathy, you got the $25 gift card to Rucker John's. You've got... you're also going to get the gift pack from Miss Ann. We'll throw in Miss Ann's cookbook for you, Ann's Dumplings, and an oil change from Dave Davis's East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. Kathy Floyd, you are
a stinking genius.
A stinking genius.
Thank you.
Hold on, Michael. I'll tell you how to get your gift card. All right, let's take a break. We're running a little behind now, but we got Heather with news headlines next, and then more Talk of the Town. We'll be right back.
Welcome to East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. It's the Jeep Celebration event. Lease a Grand Cherokee for only $289 a month. Save big this fall at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us!
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
It's golf season, and now's the time to get to Gordon's Golf Ski and Snowboard for everything golf. Gordon's carries all the high-quality brands of clubs, including Ping, Titleist, Mizuno, Callaway, and TaylorMade. Get your old clubs repaired, reshafted, or regripped. Come in today and let our teaching pro find the right fit for you. We have a wide selection of clothing, including Travis Matthew, Adidas, Oakley, Mizuno, and Puma. We have Echo and FootJoy shoes, too. The Sky Caddy GPS is a must-have for every golfer. Gordon's Golf Ski and Snowboard, East Arlington Boulevard, Greenville.
When you're on the go, it's Trade Wilco. No matter where you go in Eastern Carolina, there's sure to be an attractive and always clean Trade Wilco Hess station nearby. For the absolute lowest prices on gas, groceries, and travel necessities, stop at any of the Trade Wilco Hess stations throughout Eastern Carolina. Keep your eyes on the road, but remember to look for the green and white Hess sign. The best part? No one supports the ECU Pirates more. So when you're on the go, it's Trade Wilco.
Top Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and workweek daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bells Fork, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
That was incredible.
Check it out, guys. My new Pepsi nickname cans are here. Drink up.
Luke, can I get one too?
Sorry, man. Those are my last two. Guess you're out of Luke.
Is he all right?
Yeah, he's just really into puns. But no worries. We got plenty of bottles.
Cool cat. Nice.
Luke's like, my work here is done.
Look for Luke Kuechly Pepsi nickname cans and Panthers fan nickname bottles in stores now.
Pirate Nation, show your undaunted support this Thursday, the 22nd, by painting Dowdy-Ficklin Stadium black when ECU football hosts the Temple Owls in front of a national television audience. Kickoff is set for 7 p.m., but come early to watch the men's basketball team's open practice in Minji's. Let's show the nation why ECU fans are second to none. Order your tickets by calling 800-DIAL-ECU or purchase online at ECUPirates.com. ECU versus Temple this Thursday.
Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. It's Ram Truck Month. Lease a new 2015 Ram for only $289 a month. Save big this fall at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us
across from the crack of Arrow Creek.
All right, back on Talk of the Town at 8:36. We're running late, running really late. But I do want to thank Heather King for being here wearing her purple this morning.
Woo! Go Pirates!
She's ready for the game tonight, and she's got news headlines from WITN. Let's go to the news desk. And Heather, good morning, Heather.
Good morning, Henry. Good morning, everyone. The man police say attacked two women with a golf club in parking lots Tuesday night is scheduled for a first appearance in court right about now. Vincent Lacey was arrested early Wednesday morning after leading authorities on a chase that stretched from Greenville to Farmville and then back into Greenville city limits, according to Greenville police. Police say Lacey was likely on drugs when he stole a golf club from the Walmart on Greenville Boulevard and then used it to assault a woman in the parking lot around 6 o'clock Tuesday evening. Lacey then stole the woman's SUV, according to police. He later attacked a woman in the parking lot of the Food Lion on Easy Street, according to Greenville police. Both women suffered serious injuries and are hospitalized. Officials have determined that a fatal house fire in Beaufort County started under an attached carport. The fire broke out at a home on Chandler Road between Chocowinity and Vanceboro around 2:20 Tuesday afternoon. 71-year-old Ronnie Ennis died in that blaze, although his wife and daughter did make it out safely. One firefighter was taken to the hospital, but he's doing okay now. While the investigation is ongoing, the Beaufort County Sheriff's Office and the FBI say they do not suspect foul play. A convicted sex offender is behind bars after posing as a ride inspector at the North Carolina State Fair. Investigators say 64-year-old Tyrone Zabo was posing as a state-licensed ride inspector inside an area of the fair designated for children. The sheriff says deputies noticed he had a bottle of mace, and when asked what he was doing, Zabo said he was inspecting rides and games. Deputies looked him up and discovered he was instead a registered sex offender, not an inspector. Online records show he was convicted of third-degree sexual exploitation of a minor in 2004. He is facing new charges of being a sex offender where children are present and of impersonating a public officer. Early voting starts today across the state. The one-stop early voting for local elections runs from today through next Saturday, October 31st. The municipal elections are November 3rd, Tuesday, of course. Same-day registration is permitted today because of a preliminary injunction by the Court of Appeals on voter legislation. Speaking of voting, in March, North Carolinians will officially have the chance to approve or reject a statewide bond package. Governor Pat McCrory made a visit to Kinston to talk about the bond package at Lenoir Community College. The $2 billion referendum on the ballot will provide money for state university and community college campus projects. McCrory explained the importance of repairing, renovating, and maintaining the infrastructure. He says these changes will make the state more attractive to both businesses and residents. Those are your WITN News headlines. I'm Heather King. Henry, back to you.
All right. It is 8:39. Doug Raymond keeps sending me these things. I mean, I can't focus because he's sending me golf stuff.
Send those to me, Doug.
You know, remember last year he went down to visit his friend in Miami and he brought back all this golf stuff?
I'm texting Doug now.
Wait a minute. This This is my cram down, not yours. You can't.
I know it is, but I never get in on the goods.
He goes down. This guy like is a top TaylorMade golf rep down in the Florida area, and he's listening online right now. Dan Ridgway, Dan, I'd just like to say that I appreciate all the stuff that you've sent me over the years through Doug, but I'm out of it. So, but I tell you, McGee can confirm that I wear my that 17.
Yep.
Sergio Garcia hat. I wear that all the time. It's my favorite golf hat.
It's a great cap.
And I advertise for these TaylorMade guys all the time. So, you know, if you've got like an extra driver or anything that you need to get rid of here, I am not above a shameless plug to get free golf stuff.
I'm not either.
I can tell you that right now. So,
Doug, my favorite co-host.
Dan, thank you very much. I'm sorry that you had to grow up and be traumatized by Doug Raymond. But, you know, we all have a friend like that. Speaking of blender with a lid off. All right, Heather, thank you for being here.
Hey, thanks for having me.
I'm sorry you're going to miss a celebrity breakfast tomorrow morning.
I will. I'm sad I won't be able to make it either, but I hope you guys have a great success. It sounds like a lot of fun. And have fun at the Pirate game tonight.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
400 St. Andrews tomorrow morning, 7 to 9, the Family Support Network Celebrity Waiters Breakfast. A lot of great celebrities from the community. Going to be out there waiting on tables for tips tomorrow morning that will go straight to the Family Support Network, which has lost a lot of its funding, and they need the help, and they do great work, so we hope people will come out tomorrow morning. And then tonight at 5 o'clock, we've got our Pirate Tailgate shows. We get ready for the game tonight. East Carolina and Temple tonight. McGee will have a rundown of that game for us in a few minutes. I'm feeling good about it, McGee. The weather's going to be perfect. It's going to be a great night for football here in town. Going to be on ESPN2.
Line's dropped. He's down to two.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
But Pirates are still
favored
by two. It was up to 3.5 at one time.
Wow.
I'm feeling good about it. I'm feeling pretty good about it. You know, we owe them one. I think our guys will be focused tonight. So
let's hope so.
Our pregame show tonight, the Pirate Tailgate, will start at 5 o'clock tonight on 94.3 The Game at Texas Roadhouse. So come out tonight and get some tailgate stuff from Texas Roadhouse. Take it over to the tailgate fields. Or listen to the Pirate Tailgate on the way into the stadium on 94.3 The Game. 18 now in front of 9 o'clock. We got some things going on in the community we're going to tell you about when we come back. Thanks to Heather. We will be back with more Talk of the Town Thursday morning right after this.
Welcome to East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. It's the Jeep Celebration event. Lease a Grand Cherokee for only $289 a month. Yeah. Save big this fall at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us!
Across from the Crack of Barrel in Greenville.
It's golf season, and now's the time to get to Gordon's Golf Ski and Snowboard for everything golf. Gordon's carries all the high-quality brands of clubs, including Ping, Titleist, Mizuno, Callaway, and TaylorMade. Get your old clubs repaired, reshafted, or regripped. Come in today and let our teaching pro find the right fit for you. We have a wide selection of clothing, including Travis Matthew, Adidas, Oakley, Mizuno, and Puma. We have Echo and FootJoy shoes, too. The Sky Caddy GPS is a must-have for every golfer. Gordon's Golf Ski and Snowboard, East Arlington Boulevard, Greenville.
Full Service Flooring is your exclusive platinum dealer for Carndean Design Flooring. By offering a wide and impressive range of colors, textures, and finishes, you can create the looks that are unique to your home and guaranteed to last for years. Stop by Full Service Flooring today and check out our design table that makes your creations come to life. With the largest and best collection of luxury vinyl tile and Carndean, Full Service Flooring has just what you've been looking for.
The first
visit the new showroom just off Fire Tower Road behind Chick-fil-A or give them a call at 756-9308.
We've done this the fourth year.
When you're on the go, it's Trade Wilco. No matter where you go in Eastern Carolina, there's sure to be an attractive and always clean Trade Wilco Hess station nearby.
Yeah,
for the absolute lowest prices
on
gas, groceries, and travel necessities, stop at any of the Trade Wilco Hess stations throughout Eastern Carolina. Keep your eyes on the road, but remember to look for the green and white Hess sign. The best part? No one supports the ECU Pirates more. Mm-hmm. So when you're on the go, it's Trade Wilco.
Pitt County contains over 73,000 real property parcels.
Wow. Got you out of a lot of trouble.
Into over 900 neighborhoods. Pitt County assesses all property annually through the revaluation process. If you want to know more about revaluation, just call Pitt County Tax Administration at 902-3400 or email us at pitttaxassessor@pittcountync.gov.
Real close to the microphone. Uptown Greenville invites you to Freeboot Fridays, a celebration for pirate fans of all ages. Feast on fantastic food served by Uptown restaurants. Enjoy a cold beverage in the beer and wine garden. Dance to live music. The Freeboot Fun starts at 5 p.m. and continues until 8 p.m. at the Five Points Plaza. Visit UptownGreenville.com for more information on Freeboot Friday, the official pep rally of home football games.
Welcome to East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. It's Ram Truck Month. Lease a new 2015 Ram for only $289 a month. Save big this fall at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us!
Across from the track.
All right, 8:45. It's a time of year where a lot of communities are celebrating their first responders and thanking first responders for what they do. I was up in Edenton last week with the Chowan County Group. The Beaufort County folks are getting ready to celebrate their first responders with their fourth annual dinner dance. And they've got some other things happening as well over in the Washington Beaufort County area. Here to talk about that is my friend Larry Lang, who is on the board over there for this. How are you? Good to see you.
Doing great,
Did I get
Henry.
That right?
Yep, that's correct.
You are
yeah.
on the board?
I am. Thank you.
And
yeah.
with First Bank, you've got your First Bank.
Do a little plug for them. Yeah,
yeah little shameless plug for First Bank.
Yeah.
And Al Powell, who's been on the show many times before. Al's a former FBI man and has done a lot of things in the Washington, Beaufort County area, to including the starting the PAL program down there, the Police Activities League. Al, good to see you. How are you?
I'm fine. Nice to be here again. Thank you.
Nice to see you. All right. Tell us about the dinner dance, Larry. It's coming up on November 7th.
That's right. Yeah, it's at the Civic Center again this year, and it's a great time. It's $35 per person, and that includes dinner by Kaiser's and drinks, and also we've got a live band. We started with a live band last year, and we hired a new band this year called the Mighty Saints of Soul. And they are they include Randy Hignite and Johnny Bird and
some of the old Embers boys.
And they also all three of them play in the Band of Oz. And
yeah.
So it's a fantastic group. They play funk and beach and going to really get us rocking down there in Beaufort County.
I love that name, the Mighty Saints of Soul. That's a great name for a band. All right, so this is November 7th at the Convention Center, and it's all to raise money for the PAL organization?
That's correct. It's our annual fundraiser for the PAL organization. It's also our celebration. And so we're celebrating everything that we've done this year. And it's a time for us to kind of let our hair down and relax and have a great time to celebrate. And this year, we're bringing in recognition of our first responders. And we're doing that in a special way. And that's why I brought Al here with us today to talk about that.
All right, let's get into it. Al, you've always been very supportive. I know you retired in Beaufort County. We've talked about that after years of service in the FBI. And but you can't give it up, can you? You're still out there supporting the first responders, the fire police guys, and you're doing it here once again.
Yes, I am. It's a privilege. They are our unsung heroes.
No doubt.
And some of them put their lives on the line for people they don't even know.
Yeah.
And I thought that given the national climate of unfortunate incidents where there have been assaults against law enforcement officers, and then there have been some unfortunate incidents between law enforcement and the community, it was time to recognize some of the positive attributes and contributions that our first responders make at the community level. So we're focusing on the Beaufort County first responders.
I'm glad you're doing that. And this is going to be at the dinner dance. You're going to have some awards given?
Yes. We've selected four categories. We have large departments and small departments, so we made sure we keep a level playing field. We'll have an awards nomination for those first responders that are not certified law enforcement officers, but are nevertheless first responders, your EMTs, your firemen, your medical support folk, the Coast Guard and the Coast Guard Auxiliary. And then we have a law enforcement category for the Sheriff's Department and your various law enforcement departments, Aurora, Belhaven, Washington PD, Chocowinity, and the Beaufort County Campus Police.
All right, so this is all November 7th. How do you get tickets for all this?
You can get tickets at First Bank or the Chamber of Commerce in Washington. And we also will have tickets available in Belhaven at our First Bank location. Want to thank PCS Phosphate for helping us sponsor, and also First Bank for helping us sponsor this year. We've got, again, it's going to be an exciting time. At $35, it's a great deal with the band, the drinks, the Kaisers, which is going to include shrimp and chicken and vegetables. And it's going to be just a great night, fun night from 6 o'clock to 11 is when we're having that on Saturday, November the 7th.
And Larry, are you accepting nominations for these awards?
Yes, we're accepting.
I should have said Al. That's Al's category.
Yep, Al.
Yeah.
Yes, we are. We're going to take a few minutes out of the fun planned evening during the dinner dance to announce the award winners. But right now, we are accepting nominations from candidates. This is a community-driven project. The law enforcement sheriff's department and police chiefs said this would have more impact if the citizens themselves made the nominations from heartfelt activities and things. So what we're doing is encouraging the public to call in on 252-948-9439 24/7 hotline and leave the message about the department individuals with what their position is and what the activity was that they want to nominate them for. Or they can go to our Facebook page, and there's really a heartfelt video on the Facebook page that an individual named Philip Bryan did. Philip was paralyzed from the waist down in a car accident about 5 years ago.
Wow.
And first responders saved his life.
Interesting.
And in fact, Channel 9 WNCT did a very heartwarming story about him a few days ago. And Philip has become one of our main advocates in trying to get the word out to the public about how important it is to recognize our first responders in a time of need. And we also have our email address that folks can nominate, www.beaufortcountypal@hotmail.com. So those are our three main ways of nomination.
It's beaufortcountypal@hotmail.com.
Yes, it's Beaufort. www.beaufortcountypal@hotmail.com. Okay. Then our Facebook page, then a 24/7 telephone line.
Very good. November 7th?
November 7th.
And Washington Civic Center.
Washington Civic Center. I have two tickets to give away, and I don't know when you'd like to do that, but they are two tickets.
Mike,
for
are you
going
to do it now? Why don't we do it right now? We'll give two tickets away to see the Mighty Saints of Soul and be there for the fourth annual PAL Dinner Dance at the Washington Civic Center. We'll open up the lines right now, 561-8255, 561-8255. If you want to call, you can win tickets to the event.
The winning answer would be Blender.
Exactly.
Yeah, I just wanted to make one quick comment. The deadline for nominations is October 31st, 2015. Then we have an impartial panel that will select the nominations based on act of kindness, humanitarian gestures, diversity, and community response.
All right. Guys, thank you much.
Thank you, Henry.
Larry Lang, Al Powell from the Beaufort County PAL program. Again, buy tickets and support this event coming up November 7th. And thank you for all you guys do to support first responders in Beaufort County.
Well, thank you.
Good to see you. All right, we'll take a break and we'll be right back.
This month, not only will Greenville Toyota cut your payment in half, but you'll always get the Greenville Toyota Advantage, including oil changes, tire rotations, courtesy shuttle, free car washes, and loaners for life. At Greenville Toyota, if you give us 15 minutes, we can lower your payment.
It's golf season, and now's the time to get to Gordon's Golf Ski and Snowboard for everything golf. Gordon's carries all the high-quality brands of clubs, including Ping, Titleist, Mizuno, Callaway, and TaylorMade. Get your old clubs repaired, reshafted, or regripped. Come in today and let our teaching pro find the right fit for you. We have a wide selection of clothing, including Travis Matthew, Adidas, Oakley, Mizuno, and Puma. We have Echo and FootJoy shoes, too. The Sky Caddy GPS is a must-have for every golfer. Gordon's Golf Ski and Snowboard, East Arlington Boulevard, Greenville.
Pirate Nation, the East Carolina men's and women's basketball seasons are almost here. You won't want to miss the excitement in Midgey's Coliseum all season long as the Pirates tip off against fierce competition, including five NCAA tournament teams and the three-time defending women's national champion. Take advantage of affordable family fun. Order your basketball tickets today by calling 800-DIAL-ECU or go online at ecupirates.com. Pirate Basketball, this is Undaunted.
Full Service Flooring is your exclusive platinum dealer for Carndean Design Flooring. By offering a wide and impressive range of colors, textures, and finishes, you can create the looks that are unique to your home and guaranteed to last for years. Stop by Full Service Flooring today and check out our design table that makes your creations come to life. With the largest and best collection of luxury vinyl tile in Carndean, Full Service Flooring has just what you've been looking for. Visit the new showroom just off Fire Tower Road behind Chick-fil-A or give them a call at 756-9308.
Pitt County contains over 73,000 real property parcels, which are divided into over 900 neighborhoods. Pitt County assesses all property annually through the revaluation process. If you want to know more about revaluation, just call Pitt County Tax Administration at 902-3400 or email us at pitttaxassessor@pittcountync.gov.
My prescription refills.
My son's shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents' care.
Your bottles.
Cool cat. Nice.
Looks like my work here is done.
Look for Luke Kuechly Pepsi nickname cans and Panthers fan nickname bottles in stores now.
Pirate Nation, show your undaunted support this Thursday, the 22nd, by painting Dowdy Ficklin Stadium black when ECU football hosts the Temple Owls in front of a national television audience. Kickoff is set for 7 p.m., but come early to watch the men's basketball team's open practice in Minji's. Let's show the nation why ECU fans are second to none.
Back on Talk of the Town. Whoa, what a whirlwind show this morning, huh? We got a lot of stuff in, and it's a big day because game day here. East Carolina Temple tonight at the stadium. Very exciting stuff. We'll all be a little bleary-eyed tomorrow morning, but we'll be live tomorrow morning again, 7 to 9 at the 400 St. Andrews for the Family Support Network Celebrity Waiters Breakfast. We hope everybody comes out. Bring a few bucks for celebrity waiters tomorrow to give to family support, but we're going to have a good crowd out there. We're looking forward to it. It's 4 minutes in front of 9 o'clock. Let's check our sports update now. Any sports going on, McGee?
Maybe a few football games tonight, one you may have heard of. Number 22, Temple in East Carolina, 7 o'clock on ESPN2. Temple 6-0. They're eyeing their best start in school history with a win tonight. Could be the first team from North Broad to ever start a season 7-0. The Pirates 4-3. Big game tonight for the East Division in the American Conference. Temple, again, eyeing its best start, and they're off to its best start since 1941. So should be a good game tonight. The Pirates favored by 2 inside Dowdy Ficklin Stadium. ESPN2, 7 o'clock is the kick. The Pirate tailgate live from Texas Roadhouse, 5-7 here in Greenville, right here on 94 on our sister station, 94.3 The Game. Baseball from last night, Mets beat the Cubs 8-3 to complete the series sweep. New York has punched its ticket to the World Series for the first time since 2000. The Mets will now await the winner of the ALCS between the Royals and the Blue Jays. Toronto beat Kansas City 7-1 Wednesday to force a Game 6. In NFL football tonight, the 2-4 Seahawks against the 2-4 49ers. 8:25 is the kickoff from Levi Field. Hen?
All right, big night tonight. And again, don't forget our tailgate show coming up at Texas Roadhouse at 5 o'clock this afternoon. Our sports update brought to you by Children's World Learning Center and an academy, 4 5-star children care centers in Greenville, and their newest center on Arlington Boulevard with care and education for children from birth through kindergarten. Phase one of the Children's World Academy now open with one kindergarten class. And the school is going to expand through the fifth grade by the year 2020. Phase two will feature well-educated, experienced elementary school teachers. Huge rooms, beautiful state-of-the-art rooms with all the technology, including the STEAM room, which is science, technology, engineering, arts, and math in an elementary school. Can you imagine that? They got all the beautiful technology in there. And if you want to get a tour, you can call them at 252-215-9032. Children's World operates 4 5-star daycare camps in Greenville, including Children's World on Johns Hopkins Drive near the hospital, Children's World on Greenville Boulevard, a Child's Place on Moy Drive, and the new Children's World Learning Center and Academy. Great child care in Greenville. Call them at 215-9032. Call the Walton family. They do a great job with that. And it's worth it. I can tell you that. They do a great job. All right. Well, we're done. I tell you, I'm out of breath. We had a big show today. We covered a lot. First day of early voting today. Had a little primer on that this morning. And, of course, football tonight. Our tailgate show at 5 o'clock on 94.3 The Game at Texas Roadhouse, brought to you by East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. And then, of course, don't forget, come out tomorrow morning. We're begging you to come out and have breakfast. The breakfast is free, 7 to 9 at 400 St. Andrews, the old Beef Barn location. Community breakfast courtesy of Brian and Rochelle Brown from Rep Express Catering. They're going to be buying your breakfast for free. We're just asking you to leave a tip, and you'll have a celebrity waiter wait on your table. You could be waited on by Jeff Compher, the athletic director, or one of the ECU coaches. I know Heather Macy, some of the other coaches are going to come by. You could be waited on by Brian Brown or the mayor or one of the county commissioners. It's going to be a lot of fun tomorrow morning at 400 St. Andrews, all to support the Family Support Network. McGee, go Pirates!
Yeah, man. Let's do it.
All right, everybody. Enjoy the day. Remember, tailgate lots open at 4 o'clock. Don't get there before that. They won't let you in. Go Pirates. We'll see you back here tomorrow at 400 St. Andrews.
Hometown Station.